I decided to become a designer after my school. But anyway, for me, it was clear to do something creative because I started in my childhood being creative, working with my hands, playing with colors. So this was like obvious that I'm doing something in this design field at the end. And then after my school, I decided to become a product designer because then you can really work physically. I get my inspiration from, that's hard to say, because getting an inspiration is not really the case. So there is not a special way to get it, and there's not a special place to get it. It's just sometimes a question of a time. So when I'm working on a special field, when I'm thinking about for example, a new design of a lighting, really concentrated in that field, and then the inspiration is coming afterwards. So I'm trying to charge myself with a lot of impressions, with a lot of things that are around the market and that are in my environment. Then the inspiration is coming. So it's like it's by chance. Doing my studies, I was totally free. So this was the approach of the school, that you can work in an artistic field. I mean, it was product design studies. The students were supported to do something artistically. And so I was totally free. I was experimenting. I was trying with working with different materials, with different applications. I was really studying in a field that helped me to have a free mind. And then afterwards, when I went to Benjamin Hubert, it was not that clear line. So you were also asked to go into different directions and to think in different ways. Yeah, every material has its own character. And I need to study the character. And I need to look how it works in different environments, for example. And then I have to apply these conclusions into my design. So I really try to get the best out of it. And to get the best out of it, I really have to study it from the beginning. And also try to experiment a little bit and use it in different directions. I would say it's like an emotional approach, because for me, lighting is, you can really create an emotional atmosphere. So it's really atmospheric, and I try to get this feeling in the design. So working with light for me is, I think, one of the most interesting fields in design in general. I think it's definitely more hard to establish an own business as a woman, because otherwise there would be a balance of 50-50, and there is not a balance of 50-50. So there is definitely a problem. And I mean, there are several reasons. One reason is that there are less role models, for example. And in my case, I can say that I didn't thought about how it is to be a woman in design, never when I started. So I just did it. And I think this is, also something that I, how I would like to support other women, that you focus on your work. I know it's hard, but try to not think about it. And I mean, there will be an environment who reminds you that you are women, and that sometimes women are not, I would say, the best decision for some companies, but don't think about that. You really have to just go straight ahead and do it. Definitely the Netherlands. I'm really a fan of the Netherlands. I mean, they have really their own design identity. It's also very artistically, but there is also like a mix of design and art. And I think this is really inspiring for me. So I can definitely recommend to go to the Dutch cities and get into the Dutch design. If I could choose a superpower, I would choose that I need to sleep less, to be more active and to do more things, to see more things. So, yeah. I definitely need my coconut yogurt in my fridge.